Dirty Steve.
Dirty Steve.
Yes, from school. From school.
Dirty Steve.
Dirty, young Dirty Steve. Young Dirty talking Steve. Possibly 37, 36.
Was he that long?
It was that long ago.
No, Lord.
I'm talking about time here.
We're talking about time itself.
Yes, Dirty Steve, you know, funny looking young chap, you know, big ears.
One leg.
Big ears, one leg. And, well, very dirty.
It was very dirty. He had that growth that made it look as though he had a horn growing out the roof of his head.
That's right. That's,
yes,
that's
I remember him now. Yeah, Dirty Steve with the one leg and the horn and dirty.
Well, I don't know if you recall.
I don't.
But perhaps this might remind you. Do you recall the time that Dirty Steve got stuck in the chimney?
Now, I do remember something about that.
Yes.
Wasn't it when we were facing some financial difficulties at the school, I remember, and we were told we'd have to take
That's
on
right.
extra work?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
They laid off the nurse, and they laid off the gardener, and they
and
laid
the porter.
Off, the porters were laid off, and I did a small amount of fagging, as yes. I recall, and Dirty Steve... You're already yes. dirty, so I think you can have the choice of being outside rolling in the pig muck.
Yeah.
Or you could take on the role of the chimney cleaner.
Yes.
So Dirty Steve went up the chimney.
There were a lot of chimneys to clean.
There were.
At the school.
There were.
Very,
but the unfortunate thing is, if you recall, Dirty Steve with the horn on the head and the one leg, he wasn't a thin boy.
No.
He was quite rotund.
He was huge.
He was. There was a mass of him. I don't know what they fed him on at home.
Well, not quite sure, but yes, he was a big, big lad.
Big boy.
Big lad.
Big boy, yeah.
Proper rugger.
So he went up the chimney, yeah,
yes,
you're quite
yes.
right. He
and,
went
and
up the chimney.
He got stuck.
Got stuck up the chimney.
He did. I mean, if you, you know, retrospect is a fine thing. When you sit back and look at it now... size of him, the size of the chimney, you can pretty much foresee that sooner or later, always going to get stuck up a chimney.
Well, that's
chimneys
it.
Being so small.
Yeah. Well, this is like trying to put 56 into 2.
Yes.
It doesn't go.
But at the time,
yeah.
you know, we were young, we didn't foresee that kind of issue.
Nobody did. And I don't recall Dirty Steve saying he wouldn't do it. I don't recall he was asked.
No.
I think it was just, Dirty Steve, you're doing this.
You know, you're right. I don't think anyone told him to do it.
No.
I just think he went up there of his own accord.
He may well have gone up there of his own accord. Now, do you recall when we realised that he was gone up the chimney? I don't know if you remember, but we shouted up, Steve! Steve! Yeah. Dirty Steve! Dirty Steve! He's still up there. And you get this muffled coming from him, which I think meant, yes, I am. And... well, come down then, because, you know, matron's got the big spoon covered in the lovely stuff, and she wants you to take it. And there was a muffled cry again, Dirty Steve, Dirty Steve, come down, and eventually, we ascertained, and I remember this well, and you were there.
Yes.
You were there.
Oh, right.
No, you were there, I remember that you were there. You were there, and I was there, and everybody else was there, and if they weren't dead... they'd say that you and I were both there.
Right.
But they aren't here, because they're dead. But this isn't the point. You were there, and I was there. And I said, or someone said, we need to think of what to do here, so we thought of what to do. Now, were you in the team that decided to work from the bottom up? Or from the team with the team that decided to go from the top down?
I recall now. Yes, I was from the top.
You were from top.
Yes, we had the task of throwing down matron's scones.
Yes,
down the chimney to feed. Because Steve's a big lad.
Steve
big
was
boy,
a big lad. You know, big boy.
Big appetite.
Yes,
and you know, obviously in discomfort, we had to calm him down, and one of the methods was to feed him.
Feed him lots.
Yes, so matron brought up a plate of scones.
Yes.
You remember those hard things?
I remember them.
With things that resembled currants. I'm not sure if they were, But we had to throw them down the chimney at Steve.
Yes, hit him.
I think he enjoyed them. I mean, he yelped with joy time we threw one down.
He was a big
kind of
boy.
Like a,
he was a big boy with a big horn and one leg, and he would have loved that, I think. He would have loved that. So you threw them down at him.
So what were you doing? Were you working from below?
We were working from below. So whereas you were in sort of working from the fireplace and Prestwick Hall level 3 down, we were in Prestwick Hall level 2 with the fireplace there working up. Now we heard the yelps of delight and we thought, well, he's happy. He's definitely happy. But we need to get Dirty Steve out.
Yes.
We thought, we can't leave him out there. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to think, what is the best way to do this? Well, there were two things that we thought we should do here. The first thing was we thought, he's a big boy.
Yes.
There's a lot of Dirty Steve up there.
Certainly was.
There certainly was. So we got a stick, a very sharp stick, very long, sharp stick. And we thrust it up the chimney and we're poking him with it and we're shouting, Dirty Steve, you fat bastard! Dirty Steve, you fat bastard! And I thought I heard him crying, but I can't imagine why he would. So we kept stabbing him. He didn't come down. And we thought, well, Dirty Steve, what's this about? So then we had a brainwave. And we thought to ourselves, he's made largely of fat.
Ah.
Now, the boy was, I don't think I'm underestimating here if I say he was about 94% fat.
Yes.
So I had a brainwave. How do you get rid of fat? You heat it up.
Yes, burn it away.
There we are. So we set a fire in the fireplace.
Ah.
And we got it stoking, you know, good roaring flame on it. Shouting, Dirty Steve, you fat pig. Dirty Steve. Poking him with the stick, setting fire to it. And all we could hear was screaming of joy and crying. You fat pig. You're enjoying this, aren't you, big boy? You're enjoying this. And then I thought I heard the words, I want my mother. I don't know what he was talking about. So we kept poking him and poking him. And then, I don't know if you remember, but it all went very quiet.
I do recall that moment. That's around about the same time that I smelt a strange burning smell.
Which
is when Matron said, boys, follow me, we can't stay here any longer. I've always been curious about what happened to Dirty Steve.
Dirty Steve?
I mean, one minute he's there, chirping away with glee, with scones.
Scones and sticks and a fire up his arse.
Yes, next minute nothing.
Silence and nothing else. And no, I don't know what became of him. I don't recall seeing him at prep the next morning. I think maybe he went to a different school.
Probably.
Dirty Steve.
Let's drink to him.
One horn, one leg, fat